I remember it was a whole year of you training and then your body started to transform. And when you look at how you look now in comparison to 2018, 2017, there's a difference in the way that your complexion looks. Like now it does look younger. It does look more vibrant. If you had to break it down to like three simple things that you do regularly, that if you know if you didn't do it, your skin would not look this young, what would those three four things be?
Well, in the past, I drink occasionally, sometimes.
Like what kind of drink?
Alcohol.
Alcohol, okay. So before, you're saying you used to drink alcohol. Mm. Okay, that's fine. Like everybody,
now, no more
alcohol. Everybody enjoys
first,
alcohol.
Cut out alcohol.
So you cut out alcohol completely.
I would say 98% of the time.
All right, so on the rare occasion of birthday, somebody else's birthday, Christmas, New Year's, something like that. But besides that, probably no other alcohol.
Even on occasion, I would not drink a glass. Maybe a sip with my family. I just have a sip because I know I don't need it. Somehow, I don't know why, but my body doesn't really need it. So I would just have a sip, just to taste what's like, so that's it.
Got it.
And then second, of course, biggest thing is nutrition. Mm. Oh my goodness.
What's the number one piece of nutrition? I mean, there's so many things that we use now to help keep our bodies young, but if you had to give the one vital one, what's that one vital piece of nutrition that you would not let go of because it benefits you that well?
Calorie-free water.
Lots that was of a joke, water. Folks. That was a joke. Yeah, no, water. Okay,
water. Yeah, water's number thing. I used to hate water, but now I drink anywhere from 2 to 4 liters of water a day.
Hydration is super important.
Yes.
Right. And a lot of times when the skin looks older, it's not that it's older, it's just dehydrated, it's dry.
Right.
And when the skin's dry, it looks very brittle. When it looks brittle, it has a tendency to be classified as visually older looking skin.
Right. Third, I have to say, I got rid of a lot of sugary food. I used to have pastry a lot. But now, my diet includes 50% protein. Before, my diet is probably only 10% protein. Because protein is give us the muscle growth, elasticity, right? So 50% of my diet comes from protein. And 25% carb, and of course, 25% fat. So really focus on what gets me the result. So like I say, before maybe 80% of my diet comes from carb, and a lot of the carb are from sugar.
Right.
Simple sugar.
That's so interesting, because I actually remember when she was coming in to train with us, with me at the gym that we were at before, 2018. Right. I remember it was a whole year of you training, and then your body started to transform. And then one time early in 2019, I remember you came in for your warm-up, and I looked at her and I said, something's different about you. And she just kind of smiled and she's, oh really? And I said, yeah, you look younger. And I couldn't figure it out because, I mean, I was there to train her. I wasn't there to figure out why she looked younger, but I had noticed. And I said, hey, you look younger. Whatever you're doing, keep it up. And what I found out was that she did cut out alcohol, which by the way, we're not against alcohol. Like if you like drinking, you drink, right? It just becomes a question of what do you like more? And in this case, cutting out alcohol for Helen allowed her body to keep the hydration versus become dehydrated, which is essentially what alcohol does. Anything past 1 ounce per hour that's drank into the body, the liver can't filter it properly. So that's what ends up backing up all that alcohol, keeping it in the stomach, and that's usually what ends up affecting the skin over time. Number two, when she was talking about the transformation, this was not an overnight success. Like a lot of people are looking for the fast. No. This happened over the course of approximately about a year. Because remember, I was training her, preparing her for a competition 5 days a week in 2019.
Yes.
2018, I was seeing you about 3 to 4 days a week at the gym. And her skin wasn't changing overnight. Like it was a very gradual effect. So when you are looking for your transformation, you've got to give yourself ample time. And I know that's not the most popular thing to say because everyone's looking for fast, but remember, easy come, easy go. And if you get it overnight, there's a lot of times where people get things so easy, they don't appreciate it. And that includes us. Sometimes if we don't put some effort into it, then we don't value it as much. And one of the reasons why she values her body and her skin is because she's had to work really hard for it. So there's a lot of value in hard work and becoming really happy, like self-honored about your results. So give yourself that time.
Yeah, and I also learned that everything is an acquired thing. Like a lot of the food taste, I didn't like it at the beginning, but then you can learn to acquire to like the taste.
Right.
Like a lot of food I didn't like, and then if you eat more and then you get a habit of liking it. That's the beauty thing about, you know, the transformation, the habits. You can change the habits.
Right. All habits take some time to change, and we could hate them in the beginning. But just like what you said, when people start to notice improvements in themselves, that's when it becomes addictive, and not a bad addiction. Like, we're all addicted to something, right? But the question is, does your addiction support your goals? Does it make your life better? Does it make you happier? Like, does it make your life and yourself and the people around you better? So if you've got habits that are helping you become younger, stronger, leaner, reversing time per se, then those are some great addictions to have.
Yes.
And that's what she got addicted to, was not just the process, but every time she did the process, she looked younger. Every time she did the process, she ended up getting stronger. And that's where the secret, what we call this, isn't really not a secret, but everyone's looking for that magic tip. That's the real secret, is getting hooked on the process of becoming younger.
Right. Like there's a saying, right? How do you eat an elephant? It's hard when you look at it if you have to bite it one big bite. But then what happens when you think about chopping the elephant into pieces, then you can still enjoy it and not have to like swallow it the whole time, right? So the process is actually enjoyable if you know how. Remember, 50 is the new 30. If I can do it, so can you.